Cayman campus sports journalist Seaford Russell Jr. here at Motions Unlimited in Georgetown, joined by a very special guest, of course, Cayman's first gymnast to ever represent at the Olympic Games, the talk of the town, Raegan Rutty. Raegan,
thank you.
You're back here in this gym, kind of the place that you got your start.
For sure.
Like a full circle.
Yes.
How does it feel to be back home and in this gym, about to speak to some young ladies that are hoping to join in the same footsteps as you?
It's amazing. You know, I think this has been my favorite trip back home, just because of all the welcome and all the messages I keep getting, and everyone keep coming up to me, like if I go to the grocery store or just anywhere, and just saying how proud they are of me. It's just amazing. And being back here where it's all started, literally at this gym, is where I first had the dream of going to the Olympic Games. It's just so nostalgic and a very fulfilling feeling, knowing that all the hard work I put here and knowing that I made the little four-year-old Raegan who started here proud.
Just talk to me a little bit about how it has been back home. I know that you've been through quarantine and you've definitely been out in to the beaches. Just talk to me about that.
So I had a quarantine for, I did the 10-day quarantine, and I think that was really important for me after going to the Olympic Games and all the hype and excitement and everything, coming back home and on just being completely by myself, being able to decompress and process that I did in fact just go to the Olympic Games. Like, I remember sitting in quarantine and be like, oh, I did that. Like, I actually fulfilled my dream. And it was really good, I think, for me mentally, just being able to sit and finally just breathe and relax and honestly just not worry about anything, because it's always been school gymnastics. But I could just sit on the couch all day if I wanted to, which never really happened before. So that was amazing. And then, you know, just like I said, being out in like the grocery store, like walking around Cayman Bay, just everywhere like that, and just people coming up to me, shaking my hand, saying they're so proud of me. It's just amazing.
And I know you have on the jacket now to cover up the first tattoo, but
can
you just tell the public what tattoo you got?
So I think I can roll it up. I did get the Olympic ring tattoo. As a young child, my parents always promised me, they said the only tattoo I'd ever be allowed was if I made the Olympics, and I think they said that thinking, yeah, she's not going, but here I am today with an Olympic ring tattoo. So my dad was very clear on saying that that is the first and last, so that's fine by me. It's special.
Absolutely. And I see mom in the building here, but we can just talk a little bit about her as well and how the family support has been in this journey leading up to the Olympics.
You know, my family has been there the whole time. They're the ones that allowed me to chase after my dreams. They gave me all the opportunities and all the love and support that they possibly could, and even more. Like, they just always exceeded expectations for me. So it feels really good to know that I made them proud, and it's even special to have my mom. Just, she's gone to literally every competition I've ever gone to, so she's truly been there every step of the way, watching me in the crowd, supporting me, even if I fell, just knowing that she still loved me, obviously, and was always still proud of me. But especially being at the Olympic Games, having my mom with me was just unforgettable and super special.
Based on your performance, how happy were you with that?
Obviously, you train your whole life for however many seconds you compete actually for, but for example, like a floor routine is 1:30. You train your whole life to compete that 1:30 routine, and you obviously want it to be the best routine you've ever done. You want each routine to be the best you've ever done, but obviously that wasn't my best. But the thing is, nothing will ever take away from the fact that I did compete at the Olympic Games. You know, I'm one of the best in the world, and I'm the best for my country, and nothing can ever take that away. So I hold on to that, and just knew that I know that, honestly, if you look back, I think I had the most fun out of anyone there. So I think that says a lot. Obviously, I wanted it to go better, but like, nothing can ever take away the fact that I'm an Olympian.
One of the things we were talking about in the office while watching the Olympics, out of all the athletes, you just had this personality that it seems that it cannot be touched in terms of people negativity seeping in. Mm-hmm. You just seem so positive throughout the whole thing.
Yes.
Is that how you are all the time?
I try to be. I definitely think life is how you react to it. Anything can happen, and you can kind of choose to smile. I mean, obviously I had mistakes, but yeah. I was just so happy to be there. I think nothing could take away that just gratefulness that I was feeling during the whole time.
How does it feel to be back home and to give back to these young girls, and what is your message to them?
I mean, for me, I've been the best gymnast that's ever come from Cayman Islands. I've made it further than anyone else. I would hate for it to stop where I've gone. My goal now is to help the younger generations to come up behind me. I'd love for them to do bigger, better things than I ever did. You know, I want to say that I was the pioneer of Cayman Islands gymnastics, and that's an amazing title. I was the first ever to do many things, you know, all these flags. I was the person that put them up there. So I would love to help the younger girls here, even the guys, just represent the Cayman Islands any way they can for gymnastics and just continue to make strides in history for our country.
Well said.
The
next chapter in your career is, of course, school.
Yes.
You'll be heading off to Florida, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, so this will be my second year at university. So.
And I know that you train in Texas with your coach over there at a local gym, I think.
Yes, Grace Gymnastics. So I was training, so I left at Cayman when I was 14, trained in Texas, and then obviously I turned 18, I graduated high school, I went to the University of Florida. I trained at a club nearby, but then COVID happened, the coach that was there couldn't take me to a competition, so I went back to Texas for the time being leading up to the Olympics.
What's next in terms of competition? What are you looking at next?
I'm not too sure exactly. I'm definitely trying to embrace the moment and just live right now, and almost starting to try and flip the switch and focus onto the younger generation. I'm still going to do what I need to do, but I'm actually going to start coaching at a gym in Gainesville, so I'm already trying to start working on the younger generation, getting going.
That's really good to hear that your plans is to give back.
Yes.
But in the distant future, is the Olympic Games Paris on your radar?
I think we'll just have to wait and see. I'm not exactly sure yet, but yeah.
Raegan Rutty, Cayman Islands, yours truly. Sifa Russell here, reporting from the Motions Unlimited gym. Raegan, thank you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you.